In this video, we are going to go over the different types of plastids. Plastids are double-membraned organelles found in plants and some algae. There are many kinds of plastids, including the proplastid, etioplast, amyloplast, eleoplast, proteinoplast, chromoplast, and the chloroplast. Many of these plastids are able to convert into one another. The first plastid we will look at is the proplastid. They are the precursor form for most other plastids. The other plastids are also sometimes able to reconvert back into proplastids. Proplastids are found in the meristematic cells. They contain no chlorophyll, have little to no internal membranes, and do not possess all the enzymes required for photosynthesis. The next plastid is the etioplast. Etioplasts are formed from proplastids and seeds when they undergo germination in the dark.
This process is sometimes reversible.
They also do not contain chlorophyll, but instead the precursor to chlorophyll, protochlorophyll, which is a pale yellow-green pigment. The internal structure consists of semi-crystalline tubes called the prolamellar bodies. Etioplasts can convert into chloroplasts with exposure to light. When exposed to light, the protochlorophyll converts into chlorophyll and the prolamellar body changes into the thylakoid and stroma.
This process is reversible during long periods of darkness.
The next plastid is the most familiar one, the chloroplast. Chloroplasts are formed from proplastids when developing in the presence of light, and as mentioned, also from etioplasts after the plant is exposed to light after being in the dark.
Both of these processes are reversible.
They have chlorophyll as well as the thylakoid and stroma structure within.
Chloroplasts can be converted into chromoplasts. This occurs in ripening fruit and in leaves in autumn. This process is sometimes reversible.
The next type of plastid is the chromoplast.
Chromoplasts are formed from proplastids and chloroplasts. Both of these processes can be reversible.
Chromoplasts contain carotenoid pigments. These create the yellow, orange, and red pigments. Chromoplasts are often found in flowers, fruits, and leaves during autumn. The next plastids are a group of plastids collectively called leucoplasts. Leucoplasts are a group of plastids that are all non-pigmented. They are found in areas such as the root and seeds that do not need or have pigmentation. There are three main specialized forms of leucoplasts: eleoplasts, proteinoplasts, and amyloplasts.
These are formed from proplastids.
The first of these, the eleoplasts, are commonly found in seeds and are specialized to store lipids. The second of these, the proteinoplasts, are also commonly found in seeds but are instead specialized to store proteins. The third of these, the amyloplasts, are found in seeds as well as roots and are specialized in storing starches. Amyloplasts can be converted into chloroplasts. For example, this is what happens when roots start greening on exposure to light.
This process is sometimes reversible.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe and hit that like button.